Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: London Mayor Sadiq Khan, who is currently on a visit to India, paid tributes to the martyrs of the Jallianwala Bagh massacre in Amritsar on Wednesday. He added that it was time for the British government to apologize for the tragedy that killed hundreds. Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has expressed solidarity with the soldiers and ex-servicemen of the Indian Armed Forces as he appealed to the people to donate generously for their welfare on Flag Day. He said that the money will be used for the rehabilitation of war widows, disabled defence personnel and ex-servicemen. At least 20 prospective BJP candidates have applied for anticipatory bail at different places in Punjab. The fear misuse of official machinery by the ruling Congress leaders to target rival candidates in the local body elections. The SAD and the BJP have complained to the State Election Commission in Punjab. Officials are allegedly not issuing no-due certificates to their candidates ahead of the December 17 municipal elections. Ruling Congress and opposition SAD supporters have clashed openly in the presence of the Punjab police in Firozpur district in the run-up to the municipal elections, though no casualty was reported. Around 30 inspectors of the Punjab State Civil Supplies Corporation have been given key assignments despite advice from the State Vigilance Department against giving them such responsibilities. They were arrested last year in a suspected recruitment scam and are currently facing trial. The NIA has arrested another person involved in the murder of RSS leader Ravindra Gosayan in Ludhiana. Bahar Singh was arrested from his residence in Uttar Pradesh, Meerut on charges of supplying a homemade weapon to main accused Hardeep Singh. The Haryana government will lodge an FIR against Fortis Hospital in Gurugram. This is for causing death by negligence of 7-year-old Adya Singh, who died of dengue on September 14. The dengue season has almost come to an end with the drop in temperatures. However, with a total of 15,108 cases reported this year, it has proved to be the worst year for the state in terms of the spread of the disease. The team of Fukre Returns has sought blessings at the Golden Temple before the Bollywood film's release on Friday. Varun Sharma, Pulkit Samrat, Richa Chadha, Manjot Singh and Ali Fazal, along with director Mrigdeep Singh Lamba, visited the holy temple. This is the end of the news bulletin. But stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.